Ridiculously powerful and impressively thin, the Predator Triton 700 has no problems taking what you throw at it, but it gets almost too hot to touch under load and lacks features that key competitors offer for less. When it comes to raw specs, the Acer Predator Triton 700 sits pretty high atop the gaming laptop market. There is so much power packed into an impossibly thin chassis here, it's an impressive triumph of engineering. That said, it's not unique for a high-quality laptop to be both thin and powerful. For instance, the Asus ROG Zephyrus is slightly thinner and packs similar hardware inside, while the Alienware 15 R3 is comparatively much thicker while offering slightly less in the way of power. Both the Zephyrus and the Alienware beat out the Triton's $2,999, £2,999, $4,999, price tag while including arguably better screens. Both of the Triton's competitors have displays with 120Hz refresh rates, but all three laptops have G-Sync enabled displays to cut down screen tearing. Price and availability. The Triton 700's jumping off price is $1,999, £2,999, $4,999. That drops the graphics card down to a GTX 1066GB and cuts the RAM in half, but otherwise they're identical machines. The entry-level model isn't available in Australia, so, if you really want one, it will set you back $4,999. In the UK, the available models aren't yet for sale, but they're identical to the US, with the exception of the higher-end Triton having 1TB of storage. Value-wise, the Triton runs neck and neck with the Zephyrus and Alienware. They trade some features for others, but none of them really leap ahead in terms of value when up against the other. They're all enormously expensive, even at their lower-end models. That said, at least the Triton 700 is upgradable. By removing the bottom panel, you can up the RAM inside to a max of 32GB and the SSD to up to 1TB of capacity. Design. The Predator is unassuming for such a powerful laptop. It lacks the audacious design of similar computers, and is probably the most understated of the three when closed. A Predator logo on the lid is the only thing really giving away its purpose as a powerful, mobile gaming computer. The inside, however, is quite attractive, but simultaneously takes some getting used to. Form follows function, but in the case of the Triton, it's hard to figure out what elements influenced its unusual design. There isn't a trackpad below the keyboard, like you'd expect to find. Instead, the keyboard runs all the way along the bottom edge and a beautiful piece of glass sits directly below the screen.